Yahweh told Moses to tell the children of Israel that the Torah and the Ark of His Covenant would serve to be a witness against the children of Israel. He gave this warning to them at the time that He gave the Song of Moses to them. He gave them the Song of Moses in order to be a witness against them at the time of the end. This means that the Torah and the Ark of His Covenant were also to serve as a witness against Israel's descendants at the time of the end. This is recorded in Deuteronomy chapter 31. Take this scroll of the Torah and put it in the side of the Ark of Yahweh Elohim's Covenant so that it will be there to be a witness against you. Because I know your rebellion and your stiff necks. Behold, you have been rebellious against Yahweh while I'm still alive with you this day. How much more so will you be after my death? When Israel moved locations or when they went into war, carrying the Ark of His Covenant was the responsibility that was given to the Levites. The Levites are those whom He set apart to serve Him as priests. This means that the Levites are symbolic of being priests unto Him. Yet His word says that all of Israel was to become a kingdom of priests unto Him. This is recorded in Exodus chapter 19. And Moses went up unto Elohim, and Yahweh called him out of the mountain, saying, Stand boldly, and say to the house of Jacob, the children of Israel, You have seen what I did unto the Egyptians, and how I bare you on eagle's wings, and brought you unto myself. Henceforth, if you will indeed hearken to my voice, and hedge about my covenant, then you will be a special treasure unto me, above all the people, because all of the earth is mine. And you will be a kingdom of priests unto me, a set-apart nation. These are the words which you shall speak to the children of Israel. Notice the if and the then in verse 5. Yahweh's word contains the same if and then throughout His word. His only begotten Son spoke the same if and then. This is the if and the then that most of you choose to ignore in your rebellious, uncircumcised hearts. Each and every one of us must walk with Him in His covenant in order to become part of His eternal kingdom. This means that each and every one of us must bear His Ark of the Covenant in our walk. We must bear His covenant in order to become part of His kingdom of priests. Bearing His covenant is walking with Him in His word with His statutes and judgments. His Torah is part of His covenant to become His set-apart people. His only begotten Son testified to this same fact. The Levites actually carried the Ark on a physical plane, and they were commanded to do so in a very detailed fashion. This means that each of us must bear His covenant and that which is part of it in a very detailed fashion and on a physical plane. In other words, we must bear His pathway that is alongside of His covenant in a detailed fashion. And doing so should not be grievous to do so in our hearts. If it is, then there is something wrong with your heart. And I will tell you what is wrong. Your heart is not circumcised. Some of you know the story of Uzzah when the Ark was being returned to Israel. He reached out and touched the Ark of the Covenant when the ox stumbled and Yahweh smote him. Why did He kill him? It was because Uzzah rebelled against Yahweh's instructions on how to bear the Ark. If you think that detail in how we are to serve the Most High is not important, you have simply been deceived into believing into lies. In one of the last videos, I spoke where Yahweh's word says that we are not to add to nor take anything away from His word. Most of you could care less what His word says to do or not to do. Everything that is recorded in Yahweh's word is significant in His plan to build His eternal family. Everything is there by His perfect design, and it is there to point us to His perfect design. If He charged us to become a kingdom of priests unto Him, then He obviously would have set forth a pattern in His word for us to follow in order for us to accomplish this in us. And He did. He not only set this pattern forth in His instructions for the Levite priest to serve Him in a particular manner, including bearing His Ark in a particular manner, He also did so through sending us His only begotten Son in the image of His word to follow. Following His Son is following the image of His word. And the image of His word says that in order to become part of His kingdom of priests that are set apart to Him, we must bear His Ark of His covenant. And alongside of the Ark of His covenant is His Torah with His statutes and judgments. There is a reason why He told Moses to tell us that at the time of the end, that the Torah and the Ark of His Covenant would serve as a witness against those whom did not bear them. There is a reason why He recorded that only the children of Zadok will be able to approach unto His table in His sanctuary. Zadok stood with His anointed servant David, and he carried the Ark of Yahweh's Covenant, and he remained faithful to Yahweh's anointed. Zadok remained faithful to David even when the self-appointed Absalom fought to take his father out. Those of you who have rebelled against me are soon going to find out how important that it is that you stand with Yahweh's anointed. There is a reason why His only begotten Son said that the only way that we can have eternal life awarded to us in His Father's kingdom is if we follow after Him in His footsteps. He hearkened to His Father's words that He spoke through His Father's other prophets. He not only hearkened to them and told us that we must do the same, He magnified them. There is a reason why the high priest was symbolic of our Messiah being our high priest. The high priest serves Yahweh's inner sanctuary that houses the Ark of His Covenant and the Torah with His statutes and judgments. For those of you who think that Yeshua replaced the need for you to bear His Father's Covenant and His Torah, you are willfully delusional. If you think that you are under some new covenant that replaces the need for you to do so, you simply have a rebellious, uncircumcised heart and your head is buried deeply in the sand. You have to reject nearly everything that our Messiah and the rest of His Father's prophets spoke in order to believe this belief. And dying, you will soon die if you do not turn from your rebellion to His word that He spoke through His Son and through the rest of His prophets. Thus saith Yahweh Elohim,